What's up, guys? Dustin Newby here. That was like a southern accent. Oh, jeez, Louise, I'm losing my voice. So last time we did our re-sign phase, and it went pretty good, I think. We lost Kyle. We're going to lose Kyle Kaminsky, but not too bad. We got $5.565 million to work with, so let's go into free agency, see what happens here. There are other D on the market right now, so again, I'm not too worried. Like, there might be somebody who wants a little bit less. All right, cool. So let's just check out the free agents here. UFAs. Spezza. Ooh, not bad. Wisniewski. Kostitsyn, Kaminsky. Yeah, look at Kaminsky. He wants so much money. That's crazy. Matt Carl, 4.8 though. Still quite a bit. Team interested one. Is there any other D that are like... I'll take an 84 D. That's not bad. Roman Pollock. Defensive defenseman. His defensive stats aren't even that great. He's only got like an 83. So. Ryan Whitney. How is he an 84 overall? That makes no sense. Offensive. Oh, that's probably why he's offensive. Jonathan Erickson. Defensive defenseman. His stats aren't even that great either. Jeez. Mike Weber. I was like Shea Weber, but it's not him. Shh, it's not him. Weber. Okay, let's just see what we're parting with Kaminsky. I think it's because Kaminsky's like overall all well, like pretty darn good. Yeah, like he's got an 88 defense awareness. James Wisniewski. Yeah, he's more of an offensive guy. Kaminsky is all around awesome, so because we shaped him into being an awesome player. But no, he had to go and leave. Defensive. Is there a defensive awareness category? Let's go by that, actually. Okay, so this is the top defensive awareness. And we'll check out their overalls. Patrick Sharp's on there, eh? Oh. Todd Kaminsky, Jared Stoll. Tyler Nixon, 79, though. Is there any other defenseman with 80? I honestly think we'll be okay. Yeah, I think we'll be alright. I'm not too worried about it. Whatever. Yeah, because defensive awareness is right there. Let's see, 84. And then, yeah, you guys start getting mid 80s. Guy's 76. 80, 81. Matthew Carl, 84. I mean, it's not awful. He wants 4.8. How much do we have? We have 5.56. So we could try and reduce on Matt Carl, maybe. And try and get like another winger, maybe. Cause, I mean, Kaminsky was only an 85, and I feel like if we sign Carl, he might get better. So, where am I going right by him? I can't even see him. There he is. 4.8 and. Salary cap. We got 5.56. Okay. Matt Carl, 5.56. That doesn't even leave us a million to work with. Yeah, I'm so I'm so like unsure if I want to do that or not. Unrestricted. Could just go out and get another third liner. That's a lot of money. Like a good price third liner. Like that's a good price. Camilleri. Sniper left wing. That's actually what I want. Yeah, we're gonna get him. For our third line, we're gonna get Mike Camilleri. 2.48. So let's put it up to 2.58. We'll just raise him 100,000. Just make it an even 2.6, maybe. Nah. Yeah, whatever. 2.58. Yeah, 2.56. Yeah, whatever. 2.6. We'll keep it like that. I'm mumbling. Just trying to get him for our third line. And then Freeburg can go on the fourth line. And we're not going to have a whole lot left. Polak. Defense awareness is 83. It's not terrible. He's a defensive defenseman. Played in the AHL last year, 38 points. 2.24. Like, that's not that bad, actually. Alex Steen. Camilleri is a good price. Polak is a good price, but he's not quite what I want. Erickson's not bad. Stick checking is 87. Shot blocking, 89. 82 for defensive awareness. We could work on that. Body checking is pretty good. Like, I just need a really solid defensive defenseman. What's this guy like? 88 stick checking, 85 shot blocking. 83, 87, 86. Shot blocking, stick checking is better for Erickson. His defensive awareness, a little bit worse. Aggressiveness, 87. Those are 86s. 86, 87. Overall, defensively, this guy's a little bit better than Erickson. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to get Roman Polak as a defenseman. I mean, we do have, like, three extra D-men anyways, so I'm not, like, too worried about it. Does he have any teams interested in him? No, okay. We'll just raise him 100,000. 5-4. 4-3-4, sorry. There we go. We'll do that. Alright, and hopefully that works. There we go. So we got Camilleri. Excellent. Camilleri will be a good third line sniper for us, I think, with Granlund as center and Cogliano. And we got Roman Polak. Alright, cool. So we basically filled our holes that we needed to. Our third line, our fourth line is going to be pretty decent too, so it's not too bad. Let's just see who else there is. I don't even. What goalies are even here? Garrett Sparks. Oh yeah, because we haven't signed him yet. Maxime Legacy. Antim Forsberg. Years wanted 5. Wow. Yeah, Garrett Sparks. I'm going to keep him. Keep an eye on that guy. Affordable. I can't afford anybody. Like, someone will definitely get Kaminsky, but. Yuri Hudler. It's amazing, like, I got an 84 and he was 2 point whatever million, so. Alright, so that should be good. Let's just sim to the start of the season. and see if we get our see if we get our RFAs to sign. Fill another year. Okay, I got one. Actually, I think most of these guys just want two ways anyways. Oh, he wants a one way. One way. I was like, maybe they just want two ways. No. Alright, whatever, that's fun. Whatever. August. September. So not a bad free agency for us. Obviously, we lost Kyle Kaminsky, but not a huge deal. We got Polak, and we do have other D anyways who are up and coming. I mean, obviously, this is our last year, but I think we'll be all right. Kaminsky wasn't. I mean, he had pretty good defensive skills, but that's all right. We're not losing a whole bunch. That's fine. We'll keep going. If someone wants Garrett Sparks, I'll take a draft pick, and then we can trade it later, depending on our needs. I mean, it is our last year, so we do have. I mean, we're gonna try and make a really good playoff run, obviously. Okay, cool. Yeah, like we're gonna try and make a really good playoff run. So I'll take a good hard look at like right before the trade deadline and see who's underperforming, who we can get, and. But right now, I feel like we filled a good third line hole. Definitely filled a good. Third line hole there. Okay, so let's. Edit lines. Well, I'll do roster moves. Actually, I won't do that now. Alright, so that'll be it. So we did free agency. It went pretty solid for us. And we'll do our team assembling and preseason next video. So not too bad. We got some good pickups, I think. We lost Kaminsky, but not a huge deal. I mean, we only have 1 year left. And I still feel like we have a pretty strong team. We got rid of Perry, and we got... what's his face? Tyler Seguin. So we should be good. All right, so that's it, boys. We'll see you next time. Yeah, that just happened. All right, later, guys.